AF is an asset database in a type of an asset view of the Pi database, the Pi server, all the components within it. And of course, not only can you look at Pi data within that AF asset database, but also non-Pi data is available through AF. So let's take a look at the structures we're going to be working with today. I'm going to switch over to the virtual machine that I'm using to run this learning lab. I'm going to open up something called the Pi System Explorer. Actually, I've already got a copy running, so let me just switch over to that. At first, what we're going to learn about is what is an AF database. As you can see, you can have more than one AF database on a Pi system, although typically I think most customers would only end up having one, or maybe one for testing as well. In addition to the database itself, within the database you're going to organize as types of assets what we're calling elements. Now, for example, here's an element called tank A. It represents a physical tank. That physical tank has certain attributes like the current level, the manufacturer of the tank, the mass, the product in there, etc. So that's an element. That's a view of your process data and also non-Pi data. This could be data that's we're getting from a relational database as well or some other source. We're looking at that using asset relative views. We are switching to a more asset relative view of data in the Pi server, as you'll notice, and AF is the vehicle for doing that. You'll hear terms like data directory describing essentially a shift towards an asset view. And this is what we're talking about. These elements, like tank A, would be the equivalent of an asset. And what we're doing is we're providing a mechanism to organize those assets. Now, in addition to the element itself, let's take a look at this library, and I'll show you the template upon which this element was based. Now, I'm glad we talked about the asset first. The asset was called tank A, and tank A has these attributes. If we look in the library, you see an element template. The template is a more generic structure that we used for creating that tank A. It was a template upon which tank A was based. As you can see, it has the same attributes. Now, I know when Microsoft describes this, they like to describe it in terms of cookie cutters. When they're explaining any kind of asset-oriented or class-oriented structures. Now, you're going to see in our exercise that we actually discuss the template first. We create the template, and then we create the element based on the template, which is a good sound way, if you're a programmer, for example, a good sound way of creating, these assets in the asset database. But I think it's a disservice to start explaining the element template before you explain what an element is. It would be like trying to explain what this cookie cutter is here to somebody who doesn't know what a cookie is. So before we can talk about element templates, we really need to know that there are these things called elements, and these elements are valuable. Now, you can create an element on its own, just like I suppose you could just, take a wad of dough and try to shape it into something that looks like a deer, or shape this into something that looks like a butterfly. You could do that on your own, but if you want repeatability, if you want something that's going to be a little quicker and easier, you would want a cookie cutter. In other words, you would want some kind of a template. So what I'd like to do, even though our exercise actually starts by discussing element templates, what I'd like to do, in fact, is start by taking a look at elements. And you really need to understand that these elements exist before you can talk about an element template to create that element. So when we talk about an element, tank A, and that element has certain attributes, let's just take it as a given that that's a useful thing. This is the equivalent of learning about a cookie. So tank A, wonderful little element. I can make use of it. For example, I can make use of it in a process book display. Let me explain. I can use my little asset browser here, my Pi System Explorer, to search through an AF database, and I can find, here's our old friend, tank A. Not only that, I can drag tank A over here, and then however I've designed that tank A, whatever graphic I've associated with them, whatever attributes are associated with it, I can easily bring that over into this display. I can drop density right here. Now we're looking at density. Now we're looking at level. So as you can see, this is what you gain when you have an element. You have this nice little object that you can drag around and use. You can search for it using a tree structure or just a conventional alphanumeric search. But more importantly, it's a valuable thing to have. It's a thing that you can hang other stuff off of. You can take something like a tank, and you can hang all different types of attributes off of that. Whoops, I'm in the wrong place. I need to go back to elements here. Now, I can grab an element like tank A, and if I look at the attributes of it, you can see, you know, these are some attributes that are hung off of that. Yeah, there we go. Here are some of the attributes hanging off of that tank. So there's pi data, of course, but then there's also other things. There's calculations, there may be data from a relational database, etc. We'll talk more about that later on. And anyway, I'd like to start my discussion just like you would discuss, you know, cookies before you discuss cookie cutters. I'd like to start the discussion of element templates by discussing elements first. And this is an element, this is how you would use it. I'm working in process book here, by the way. So let me switch back to the AF Explorer. So now that I've probably beaten to death the topic of elements and the fact that an element has attributes and it's useful, again, here's the big finish to all this. Once you've got this nice element, this element that you like, you can create an element template and then create more elements that will look and act exactly like that first element by using template, by templatizing it. It's usually the other way around. Typically, people build a template first, and then they start generating 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. elements based on that template. And of course, one of the powerful things about this is through templatizing, there are certain things like notifications, for example, that I can apply to one element within that's been built on a certain template. And then automatically, I can apply that same notification to all the other elements that are built off that template. And also, I can take a calculation. I believe density is being calculated. No, that's actually something else. Let's look at mass. Yeah, there we go, mass. That's actually a calculation. I can go in here and I can change the calculation that particular density is, or that mass is based on. And the nice thing about this is all the elements that are built on that element template will pick up that new calculation. So those are some of the reasons that we consider this a time saver, that AF can save you time, you know, once you've got your asset database built.